Big Time Boxing and Brian Amatruda. We are live. It is main event time. Introducing first, fighting out of Mornington Peninsula, please welcome Sugar King Wah!
Sugar Man, won't you hurry? 'Cause I'm tired of these scenes.
A four-time world champion, fighting out of Perth, Western Australia. This man really needs no introduction, but please give it up for the one, the only, the Green Machine, Denny Green!
Danny Green making Kane Watts play the waiting game. Watts, nervous energy burning centre ring. It's his crowd. You can hear the boos. The West Australian Danny Green, they know what's happening. Cue up men at work. Down under. Play that one more time. That's what they're fighting for, the Australian Cruiserweight Championship. I wonder how much Kane Watts will tolerate of this. Does he stay in the ring or does he go back to the dressing room? They are still in the sheds. Kane Watts has taken a seat. He's trying to relax.
Smart move.
Look at the face, though. It's a face of nerves on Kane Watts. The crowd standing, waiting, and doing it impatiently. Watts trying to block it out. Brian Armatruda, Julian Holland, Stuart Patterson, Ray Giles, all in and around Kane Watts, trying to distract him. Trying to do whatever they can to take his mind off the fact that he's been sitting in the ring for the best part of 6 minutes.
For our main event, would you all please be upstanding to sing the Australian National Anthem? Please welcome Mr. Ben Clark to centre ring. Please all be upstanding.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Live from High Sense Arena, this is the moment of truth, the moment you've all been waiting for. High Sense Arena, Melbourne, Australia, this is our main event of the evening. It is now time to separate the men from the boys. Sanctioned by the Combat Sports Board of Victoria. Board members, Bernie Barmer, Scotty Brower, Mal McGuinness, Michael Ashton and Simone Bailey. Our recorders of tonight's fights, Jenna Hayes and Kayleen Williamson. Our position at ringside, Dr. Peter Lewis. And our timekeeper, Mr. Tom Davis. IBO supervisor, Steve Scott. And ANBN supervisor, Frank Hadley. Our judges at ringside, Andrew Campbell, Jeff Eddy, Wayne Ashdown. And when the action begins, our referee in charge once again is Mr. James Bowen. Ladies and gentlemen, these two warriors now step in the ring to go toe-to-toe in the oldest proving ground as High Sense Arena, Melbourne, Australia. Once again, this is our main event of the evening. It is now time to separate the men from the boys. 10x3-minute rounds for the Australian Cruiserweight title in association with Brian Armatruda and Big Time Boxing. High Sense Arena live on main event. Are you ready? Are you ready? Without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, it's fight time! Introducing first of all, from the red corner, trained by Jules Holland from the Fighting Chris Gym. Official weight, 89.9 kilograms, standing 6 feet 2 inches tall. Tonight he's wearing the all-black fight shorts. He has a professional fight record of 20 fights for 18 wins, 11 by way of knockout, ranked number 4 in the ANBF. Fighting out of the Mornington Peninsula, Melbourne, Victoria. Please welcome the one, the only, Sugar Kane Wild. Green Zone, official weight, 86.15 kilograms, standing 6 feet 1 inches tall. Tonight, he's wearing the black shorts with a green and grey trim. He's a 2000 Olympian at the Sydney Games. Ladies and gentlemen, this man is boxing royalty and future Hall of Famer, a four-time world champion, 39 fights for 34 wins, 28 by way of knockout, fighting out of Perth, Western Australia. Please give him a warm High Sense Arena welcome, the one, the only, the Green Machine, Denny Green! Fighters, you sound please, the final instructions.
Okay, Denny, you can't explain your dressing room. I'm a good, clean fighter, obey my instructions at all time. Case of a knockdown, the new to one hand, the way I'll be. Shake hands now, come out fighting, the start of the bell.
It is main event time on Main Event Boxing. Multi-division, multi-time world champion, Danny Green up against one of Australia's finest in Sugarcane Watts. We are doing it for the Australian Cruiserweight title, a title Watts has held but Green hasn't.
And here we go, the atmosphere is electric.
It is awesome. We are scheduled for 10 3-minute rounds. Watts in the solid black green with the black, green and white, the familiar patterning of the Western Australian. Watts doubling up the left hand, going to the body early. Green at 43 years of age, conceding 9 years to the younger Kane Watts, but probably in ring, as we heard earlier, is also conceding 9-10 fighting kilos.
Danny Green looks very relaxed, very composed. He's been there, done that, just starting off nice and easy, just trying to get the measure of his man.
Watts, the right hand, firing it out, missing the target. Green's hands nice and high.
Nice and tight.
Pushing his way around the ring, Danny.
Just asserting his authority, making sure that he's not getting pushed around by the bigger, heavier guy.
Kane Watts, a full-time plumber, full-time gym co-owner. It's the first time in his 21 fights he has had none of that in the preparation. It has been boxing, 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 training 3 times a day. for the last 8 weeks for this moment. No distractions. Watts down.
Just a slip. Green looks very composed, very confident, taking the center of the ring, just sizing his man up.
Calm and confidence, two traits we associate with Danny Green and have since his debut the end of June in 2001.
And Watts understandably looking a little bit nervous, but I'm sure his cobwebs will disappear very, very soon. Or nerves, should I say.
The big stage for Kane Watts for the first time. He launches a right hand and gets a smile from the green machine.
And the crowd loving the effort.
Very popular young athlete down here. It is a pro Watts crowd.
We're in his backyard, absolutely.
Through the defenses there. Nice over the top. Yeah, very nice from Danny Green. Only one fight in the last 4 years for Danny Green. That was here last year. Almost 12 months to the day against Roberto Belonti. A win in 10 for Danny Green. So is ring rust an issue? We're about to find out.
Slow down. 30 seconds. Hey. One little water clip. That's all. Get your breathing going, man. Let's just pick up what you were doing there. You just your reflexes a little bit. Don't get slowed in. He's a bit slow in movement. Don't get slowed caught in his cadence. You know what I mean?
Well, just the feeling out round. Kane Watts there. A bit of a slip. I think he trod on his toe and went down as a result. He tried to counter Danny Green there with the right hand after Danny's jab. Danny was composed, way too experienced. Ate a little left hook there, but nothing too damaging or worrying.
In the corner with Danny Green, longtime mate and trainer. Now farmer, Angelo Hyder. All right.
His confidant.
Round number two, here we go for the Australian Cruiserweight title. 10 rounds the distance or 30 minutes of boxing. Three down already. Kane Watts down in the opening round. Ruled a slip. And correctly by our referee, James Boland. Andrew Campbell, Jeffrey Eddy and Wayne Ashton, our three ringside judges. Green's leg outside the ropes and Greeny has been rocked with a right hand in the middle of all this.
He got tagged when his foot fell out of the ring. And it was, I think Danny's looking at him like that was a cheap shot. But all his fear in the sport of boxing.
It's on here. Green unhappy that he was tagged, and not Watts knows he's got a chance.
I think you saw Green's demeanor change, his face change, and he really wasn't happy about that.
Pushing out the left hand.
Yeah, Danny looks very purposeful.
Yeah. He reads a fight extremely well himself, Danny. He's what you'd call a smart boxer.
Yeah, absolutely. Kane Watts trying to make it a rough night. Danny Green trying to keep his composure and overwhelming with his experience.
And with being 9 years the junior and 10 kilos heavier, the more Kane Watts can get on Danny Green's chest and rough him up, the better for Kane Watts.
Absolutely. And in this round, you'll start to see Watts. His nerves are starting to disappear a little bit.
Let's go.
Referee's reading the riots act.
Yeah, too early for that, in my opinion. Let him go. Big fight. Watts over the top, responding to the Danny Green shot that initiated that. Little exchange. Green trying to go around the defences of Watts. Kane with the elbows out just a little here.
Yeah, that's not a trait he'll want to stick with. Green will start working him downstairs.
Firing out the left hand, Watts. Resets and moves. trying to find the position. Almost happier at the moment, Kane Watts to counter Danny Green as opposed to initiate.
Yeah. Well, Danny is very purposeful, very forceful in the middle of the ring. He's taken the dominance, and it could be just the fact that he's more experienced. Oh, and he's tagged him with a right hook there.
Tag.
Oh, he's in danger. Yeah, he's
back
in danger.
Against the ropes. Now it's time to hold on as Green opens up. Another big right hand.
Danny
Green looking $1 million at the end of the second round. And he's been cut.
Yeah, bad cut on the top of Danny Green's head. We'll have to see if that came from a headbutt or a punch.
Wow, how quickly it changes.
You got caught. Get your head full. Give us a bit of swab for the eye. You've got to get him going backwards, huh?
Yeah. Do that, that's what we want.
A round with just about everything in it. This is when Danny Green, his right foot went out of the ring.
Off the ring and pop.
Wow.
There was the punch.
Just above the ear, and Greeny a little wobbly on his feet.
And then Danny on a purposeful mission, boom, caught him with the right hand there. Really got Kane Watson's attention.
Yeah, he certainly did. Significant shot from Danny Green, who has been busted up over the right eye, and the blood flow they've been unable to stop during the break, and it is coming down the inside of his nose, potentially affecting his sight.
It is. I think Danny's going to want to sort this out very, very quickly.
How much more can Kane Watts take after that big shot at the end of the second? He's had just 60 seconds to clear the cobwebs out.
Yeah, Danny's on a mission, and Danny really wants to take care of him before that cut becomes a real problem.
Kane Watts now has a target.
The difference in caliber is somewhat evident. Danny Green just taking control, controlling the pace, and Watts looking for that counterpunch. Danny's seeing them coming every time.
Fight number 40 in the professional career of Danny Green that started back in 2001. It is fight 21 in the career of Kane Watts. Oh. Here they go again.
Yeah, Danny took a right hand on the inside.
Hey, step back. Watch your head. Let's go, Danny. Let's go.
And a little smile from the West Australian
to acknowledge the headbutt that came in there.
He knows this is going to get rough. It's what he expected. It's what he predicted.
Danny.
It's very rough on the inside.
Fair point. You're right, Danny? You're right.
Anthony Mundine looking on intently.
Bobby, yeah, with a purposeful look.
Top there, Kane Watts just missed. Well defended from Green, who sneaks through a couple of beautiful short right hands. But the bigger, younger Watts is looking to bully Green.
Green is using great experience to tie him up on the inside, and the referee is earning every single dollar in that ring for this fight. Danny Green back to the middle where he's been for most of this fight. Lovely job. Got to take the ball.
Right hands!
Lovely right hand.
Right back.
Big right hands exchange centering. Green still with a smile on his face. Still in the middle of the ring, Green. And tying up on the left-hand side. Green firing his right away. Not long to go now, and this the third round.
Under 20 seconds, and Green is just staying composed. This is the experience. He's not panicked with a cut eye or the cut head. And he's just looking for that big shot off the jab.
Trying to fake and feign a little bit here, Kane Watts. As the bell signals the end to round number three.
Australian Cruiserweight title on the line.
It's a beauty over the right eye of Danny Green.
That's a nasty cut.
don't waste energy forcing the pop. You're forcing, trying to get in there and stuff. I want you to slow it down, but I want you to jab a bit more.
You want to
aim for the jab here. He gets down low. Don't do any more low jabs. Just put him on his chest. He'll go straight into him. Then when he starts following this and he's not sure, we'll bring him onto the snake.
Take a look at the highlights from the previous round. It got down and dirty.
A lot of inside fighting there. A lot of shots, uppercuts and hooks on the inside.
Second down.
Kane Watts using his strength to bully him on the inside.
That's exactly what Kane Watts was trying to do. The game plan evident, the game plan exposed, but it's also the game plan that Danny Green had expected as well. So no surprises in the opening 9 minutes.
I think Danny's going to look to capitalise on the success of his right hand. He's just touching that jab out, touching it out. He's going to be coming over the big right hand sometime soon.
That double left hand of Danny Green right into the chest. Such an effective weapon for so many years.
Yeah, good advice from Angelo Harder to keep that jab there.
There's a beautiful jab from Danny. Perfectly built boxer, Danny Green, in the fact, wide shoulders, long arms. Has a reach advantage more times than not.
Well, he's looking to set him up. You know, Danny Green's just touching that jab out, keeping it soft sometimes, keep Kane Watts at bay, and then come in with them with the combinations or the 1-2. But he's just sizing him up, just looking for an opening and an opportunity. And Kane is looking to counter, and that's why this big pause is there.
Watts under the front foot, trying to rough up Danny Green. Can Kane Watts dare to dream? Pushing the left hand into the face of Danny Green, who responds. Green gets him with the right hand, and it's stuck.
He caught Danny with a right hand.
Okay, let's go, Danny.
There was a wobble in the knees of Danny Green.
He got tagged with a big right hand there from Kane Watts.
Green not giving Watts any room at all now. Confident with his range, confident with his speed, obviously. Shows the natural physical strength of Danny. Pushing around and shoving around a man 10 kilos is heavier.
Exactly. Now Green's doing the pushing. Green's doing the asserting. Purely made from experience.
Right hands exchanged from both boys in the final half minute of round number four. Last couple of seconds, last chance to impress the judges before we go back to the stools for 60 seconds. Very entertaining, very good round. Danny Green, Kane Watts on Main Event Boxing.
Get the other one on his head, tell us when to take it off.
You're trying to box this fucking bloke. You've got to get in here and fight him now. You've got to jab your way in, you've got to get inside, you've got to fight this bloke.
Jab right in.
Not ones and twos. Yeah. You're just throwing one punch. Yeah. You're trying to box with him.
You're trying to do that right in.
We'll steal off you, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Now we've got to jump on him. We're going to lose. Let's lose doing it our way. Understand?
There we go. Jab from Kane Watts. Danny Green returning that nice jab as well. But good action on the inside. Danny just holding him in and just shaking his head. And there's the right hand that Danny took, wobbled his knees just a little bit.
You'd hear the really clear instructions from the veteran cornerman, Ray Giles.
Yeah.
You try to box him. Don't be silly.
Yeah.
Let's fight. Corner him, fight him, push him, punch him,
whatever
you've got to do.
Yeah. It's not bad advice.
Right hand from Watts, taken on the glove from Danny Green as he stepped away from it. Need to be reminded there to keep the left hand up, Danny Green. They've done a great job on that cut.
Yeah, the cut's been managed very well by Angelo.
Watts being beaten by the speed of Danny Green there. For a big boy and not a young fella, he's still got really good speed, Danny Green, as Watts corners him and tries to rough him up again. Throws his back against the ropes, tries to launch an assault.
Yeah, Green's reflexes and his movement is looks very good. He's obviously still got great punch power, but I can imagine Danny wants to get him out of here so that he can, you know, put that cut to rest and hopefully it doesn't get any worse.
Danny's winning this battle here. He's getting Kane back into a boxing match.
Yes.
Danny, come here. Next time you do, I'll take a punch out of him. Let's go.
Right, called for a head clash there, a head lunge. Kane Watson warned by referee James Boland. Do it again, I'll take a point. So you do one of two things. You've got to make sure you either don't do it again or you've got to make sure your next one's a good one. One good enough. That it's worth taking a point off.
Danny doesn't like being shoved around. He's asserting his authority in every opportunity he gets.
Danny blowing really hard here in the fifth.
He's either blowing or trying to spit the blood away.
A little bit of talking from Green. Back against the ropes.
There you go.
Good right hand from the machine.
Suckered him into a counterpunch.
Some countering going on here.
They're both looking for the big right hand.
30 seconds remaining in the fifth. Again, they come together. Watts squeezing down and trying to get to the elbows and the forearms of Danny Green as well.
Well, that's the only way he's going to make the fight competitive, to keep it rough inside, to push him around, to make Danny Green uncomfortable, because Danny's the far better and more experienced fighter.
An old school hip toss to the ground for Danny Green.
One point off.
Smiles all round, but Danny is not a happy boy.
Not happy.
1 point
taken off.
1 point off from Kane Watts for that throw. 1 point lost at the end of the round.
Cut the wrestling out if you can.
He's strong, man.
He's too strong, mate. He's very strong in there. It's sapping a lot of your energy.
Beach and water.
Now listen, I need you to keep creeping. I need the creep really working now.
There you go, Kane Watts pushing Danny Green back. Danny can see everything, just dodging and moving underneath. But, you know, Danny's cut looks very bad as he's taking these shots. A nice little friendly sporty kiss there. Not what you expect in a boxing ring, but nonetheless, you can get all types of things here on Main Event.
There you go. Little kiss from Danny Green, a smile on the face as we start the second half of this fight for the Australian Cruiserweight title. Watts is down. He got some with the right hand on entry.
I'm surprised the referee didn't call that.
Yeah.
He thought it for a knee down or something. But it was a clean right hand to the top of the head.
We're going to fight here. Danny Green's veteran trainer, Angelo Hyder, saying he's too strong. Don't get involved in it. And Danny's mouth guard has come out. 45 seconds into the round. Early in the fight for mouth guards to be coming out. That's normally a sign of fatigue. Trying to buy just a little bit of time.
all the weight and pressure from Watts will be zapping the energy of Danny Green. You know, he's pushing the guy around much heavier than he is.
Watts walks into a straight right hand, but then launches a counter himself, and these two boots are going at it on the ropes.
Well, Watts is complaining about punches to the back of the head from Danny Green. This is a rough contest inside.
Well, this should be playing into the hands of Kane Watts because he wants a fight, and Danny Green is presenting just that to him.
Well, Danny Green's a warrior through and through. He's not he's not going to take it. He'll fight back.
Nice shot from Danny Green down low as Watts head hunts there. Circling each other. Just over 60 seconds remaining in the round, and Green moves back to the ropes. And Green's countering right hand is what he's looking for here. He's trying to bring Kane Watts onto a straight right from the ropes.
It worked early in the fight, and he's trying to get that money punch again.
Kane Green.
Right, stand up, Kane. Press your gloves, Kane.
Both boys exhausted, every right to be. The pace has been extreme.
Yeah, it's been a ferocious pace.
Kane Watts
very close.
Had a big chance there to an open face of Danny Green. He missed it by the barest of margins. 30 seconds remaining in the sixth. And again, they clash heads, shoulders and chests. Natural aggression of two elite athletes.
The inside fight seems to suit Kane. He's using his weight and his strength to push Danny around, but on the outside, Danny's more advantageous.
The crowd once again starts the chant of Watts. More leaning he does, the more it drains Danny Green.
Exactly right.
End of the round coming, and Watts got tagged with that final right hand. It was a beauty from Danny.
You can see it coming. Yeah, he's getting on that way in. Let's go. Quick.
Take his hands out. Take his right hand. Your death curl right there. You're in the pocket.
And you're in there.
An all-action fight here, and Danny Green caught Kane, and there you go, knees on the floor. Officially, that's a knockdown in the rules of boxing. And then there was the complaint about the punches to the back of the head. Rough inside fighting, both guys landing big shots on the inside.
They are going to have welts and bruises from their ribs to the top of their heads tomorrow, shoulders, forearms, and everywhere in between.
Very true.
Extremely physical contest between Kane Watts in the black and Danny Green in the black, green and white. Centering. Again, they start the round relatively cautiously, but that lasts only so long.
Well, Danny's had easier world title fights than this.
Oh, yeah.
He's come back to Australian level and he's going to a real war. Danny's just trying to draw him onto that sucker right hand he's going to throw. The counter that has worked so well for him.
Watts, here goes the local boy. Green responds. He says, you want to fight? Let's fight.
He's hurt him real bad. He's hurt him. Oh, and he's looking for the kill, Danny Green.
A minute into round number seven. Is this the beginning of the end for Kane Watts?
Great, don't punch.
From the start of this round, I did notice Danny Green's guard is way up to where it should be.
Absolutely.
And that limits where Kane Watts can punch.
True. He's not taking him for granted. He's in for a real fight. It's been a real fight, so he's able to change gears, you know, that's the experience. And the right hand, the knees down.
Hold up, Kane. Crush your glove.
I think Kane's just very tired.
Yep, fatigue has certainly set in. How much more has he got? And has he got that one punch knockout?
Perfect. Here we go.
Kane Watts with a professional record, 20 fights, 18 wins, 11 knockouts. He has never been stopped himself, but has 11 of 18 via the short route. So he does have that one-punch power, but does he have it at this class? That's the question.
Well, if you look at the eyes and the focus of Danny Green, he's still very sharp. He can still see everything coming.
Yep.
You know. Whoa!
Nice.
Big right down from Danny Green.
Yeah, certainly was very effective from Danny Green once again. The final minute of round number 7.
I mean, Kane's doing great to stay on his feet. He's taking some big, big shots from Danny Green.
Left eye of Kane Watts starting to swell.
Right back. Don't punch Danny, step back. Right back.
So
step
to
back.
The right, as a matter of fact, but he wouldn't have it any other way.
Yeah. He's being countered coming in every single time, and this is Danny's experience showing.
Body shot from Green. That'll slow the bigger man up in a real hurry.
And round 7 out 3.
End of round number 7, and the walk back to the corner, taking a little longer for both athletes. And the 60 seconds break they get probably feels like about 6.
That's a really good round. Smart. This is pretty deep. The uppercut's there now. Set it all up with a jab. We need more movement. Don't try and knock him out inside with those big clubs and stuff.
Deep breathing.
Just stay simple, Dan. Conserve some energy. It's been very sapping out there with all this holding.
Both guys have been working very, very hard. Danny Green with his back to the ropes, but milling on the retreat, as they say, catching him with big, big right hands that forced him back there. A nice jab from Danny Green and a right hand. And these right hands are really, really telling. And Kane's done well, showing great maturity to hold on and keep him close. This is a great shot.
Yeah, from up in the stands, high in the stands of the sold-out High Sense Arena. And Danny Green has started this the 8th with the intent of this being the final round.
Yeah, he's definitely a man on a mission.
We believe Kane Watts was injured late in the round. How much has he got left? How much has been taken from him? Edging forward. Needs to make it a fight. He's been told that repeatedly by his corner. Doesn't need to try and box Danny Green. He has the superior speed and probably technique.
Yeah. But every time that Kane tries to make it a fight, Danny just obliges.
Yeah.
And gives it back. That's
Danny's a beautiful boxer, but he's a fighter, make no mistake about that. Yeah. He loves it.
And he's looking for the right uppercut and the right hook. As mentioned by Angelo Harder, the uppercut's there. Oh, nice jab, knocked the mouthpiece out.
We've got a mouth guard out here.
It was Kane Watts' mouth, and the mouthpiece came out after that jab. Oh, it was Danny Green's mouthpiece. My apologies.
Right at the halfway point of the round. Is the veteran buying time? Watts trying to crowd him back against the ropes. Danny walks away. Back into centre ring. Asks Kane to follow him. Oh, he looks for that uppercut.
And he landed it nicely.
He wants, as per instructions from Angelo Hyder, to be setting up using the jab. And then the right uppercut. That's what they think is going to finish off Kane Watts for the night.
Danny just trying to set him up, drawing him in so that he can counter him. Ooh, low blow there, low blow.
It was a low one, Danny. It was a low one.
Yeah, just a little south of the border, that one. Danny Green apologised immediately to Kane after After the shot, he looks at game for the uppercut, but still finds a right hand. Watts without the authority at the moment when they are in that grapple. He is so tired and so spent. Last 10 seconds of the round. Green thought about it.
He did. He thought
a
about
lead
that
uppercut.
Big, yeah, that big shot.
There's some good shots.
In round eight, two more rounds to go.
At the end of the round, and a little stare off, a little tension. Ray Giles blowing up at the referee. Tension from the fighters, tension from the corners.
Bending into his uppercut.
Yeah, let's see. He's going to get that next win. Moving around. He's going to get this. He's going to start throwing big shots. I know you can't okay on the ropes. I don't want you there.
No, hands up. Hands up, Danny.
There's beautiful jab there from Danny Green. Just trying to use his experience and all his ring generalship to keep him where he is. Looking for the uppercut throughout the whole round. Landed it a couple of times, but Kane did well to just tie him up on the inside.
The Green Machine. Danny Green up against Sugar Kane Watts. Two rounds remain in this 10-round contest, fully vacant. Australian cruiserweight title, a title Watts has held once, Green never before. Danny trying to go low, Watts high.
Oh, very rough on the inside. Yeah,
and a little wrench on the elbow once again.
That's right.
From Sugarcane Watts.
A lot of rough tactics on the inside, but yeah, it's that type of fight.
It's certainly turned messy, but you're right, it is that type of fight. And whilst it's that type of fight, Kane Watts has a shot.
Yeah, exactly right. Danny's looking for that uppercut on the right-hand counter.
We've seen both guys on the end of some good right hands, in particular early in the fight. Shots that have stunned both as well.
Well, Danny's strategy has just turned into just sitting back, waiting, looking for the counter. Yeah. There's the right uppercut that landed. And he's constantly looking for the right uppercut, right hand, because he's found a home for that. But he's just looking for that knockdown or KO punch.
They're still complaining about use of the head from the blue corner, the Danny Green corner. They believe Kane Watts has tried a headbutt. And Watts, the underdog, storms across the ring, looking to get back in the face of the multi-time world champ. Anthony Mundine is here watching on.
Possibly enjoying this.
There is the man.
Poker face.
Oh, yeah.
Not giving anything
it
away.
Is.
Not giving anything away.
A minute remaining. No! Watts is down!
And there's the right hand.
And Watts is saying to the back of the head.
Five, six, seven, eight. Come on,
Kane Watts' corner. Livid at that decision, and Danny Green's corner has said, now is the time.
Watch your head.
Yeah, they're urging him to hit him in the same place again, to the side, stroke back of the head. The right hand's all night and now starting to take effect.
A couple of big shots to the rib cage from Danny Green.
Watts looks tired. He looks very tired.
Green with the lead uppercut attempt. The right hand of Danny Green is proving the difference here as Watts responds.
That's right.
And we have nine rounds gone. One remain. 3 minutes only.
Live on the main event.
The last chance for a couple of deep breaths, some instructions, and a little prayer.
You can't do it. We had a game planned early, son. You've got to. I told you from the fifth round, you have to throw punches. You're not throwing punches, son. You're not throwing punches. You've got to let your hands go. You have to.
Last round, buddy.
You're bending into his uppercut, don't you see?
Don't leave with the uppercut.
Come on, Daniel.
And you'll stop it.
A great run, a lot of aggression in there. Danny Green just sizing up his distance as he moved back, looking for them big shots. And there's the right hand that caused the danger, just to the side of the head there. Right uppercut, right hand, creating a lot of discomfort for the Sugar Cane Wolves.
Here we go, a 10-round main event on Main Event Boxing. Danny Green, Cane Watts, with 3 minutes of work in front of them. The prize, the Australian Cruiserweight title, but this fight, it also means just so much more. Green wants to box, but also he wants to finish this, and he may as well.
Three.
A nice right hand.
Five, six, seven, eight.
Watts claiming. It was on the break.
That was on the side of the face this time. Danny's going to go for the kill. He wants to get the finish.
Cane Watts needs to fight. Needs to get ugly here.
I think he's tired, a little worse to wear. Danny Green looks fresher.
It is the biggest professional night of Cane Watts' young professional career. And he has handled himself with class,
very well,
with dignity. His stocks have risen. He is one tough unit. He is up against one of this country's all-time finest. Green with a nice right hand again. The shots connecting to the areas. Cane Watts.
And Watts looking very, very poor, looking worse to wear. Green's pushing him back, looking for the KO, just looking for that big, big punch to finish the night.
An amazing show of strength the last 30 minutes from Danny Green, who's conceding 10 kilos. Not that you would know. Good one jab shot to the midsection from Danny Green. Just trying to drop the hands of Cane Watts.
He is, just to get over the top with that right.
Oh, short right hands, and there was not a whole lot in that.
That's right.
As both men look at the big screens here at the Hisense Arena, they know there is just 60 seconds remaining. You would think the scorecards are in favour of Green. He might well be thinking, I've only got a last 60 seconds. But Cane Watts may well be thinking, I've only got 60 seconds.
Exactly. I mean, Danny's got scored the knockdowns in the fight, and I think his heart will be telling him, if I can just finish this fight, he wants to go out there and end it on a high note.
The countdown continues at the 30-second mark. Watts pushing out the left hand, each time missing. He's looking for one big right hand to finish it. And whilst he's inactive, Danny Green is happy. Against the ropes they go. One last chance for Sugar Cane Watts. His time is now, or his time is up. And that's how he finished. Danny Green, Cane Watts, 30 minutes of brutality.
Good fight.
Here at Melbourne's Hisense Arena.
And the supervisor, Mr. Frank Hanley, to present the belt.
They have gone at it, yet there is so much respect. There is an admiration. Cane Watts, we said during that final round, yes, son, your stocks have risen immeasurably. The way you've conducted yourself, the way you've fought, what you've shown, the heart, the strength, the power, the persistence. Brilliant.
To go 10 rounds with Danny Green is no mean feat. He's done very well.
What does that man think?
he thinks he's
number one and is confident of a victory if and when these two do it. I wouldn't leave or turn off just yet. I would be stunned if this didn't get interesting. With Mundine ringside, the king of the one-liners, but Danny Green. If sledging was an Olympic sport, he'd be close to gold medalist. He loves it as well. Will they exchange barbs?
Job done, boys.
Well, here's some action from this action-packed fight. And there's the knockdown. Just the look of discomfort on Kane Watt's face showed it all. Good body shot from Danny Green. He was pushing the action in the last round, just trying to get that KO. But it was competitive right to the end, with the bigger man using his weight to push Danny Green against the ropes.
Yeah, that it was. Both guys have given it their everything here tonight for you. Wonderful display of sportsmanship and just fearless brutality, if you want to put it that way. No use sugarcoating it. It wasn't a pretty fight. It was ugly, but gee, it was tough.
It was tough. Very tough.
Wouldn't swap it. I loved it. And it should be a formality as we head centering to Perry Kale.
Fighters to centering, please. Ladies and gentlemen, before we go to the judges' scorecard, a big round of applause to both fighters for a fantastic main event live from High Sense Arena on Main Event TV. After 10 rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard. Andrew Campbell had it 99-89. Jeff Eddy had it 99-89. And Wayne Ashdown had it 98-89. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by unanimous decision and new Australian Cruiserweight Champion from Perth, Western Australia, the Green Machine, Danny
Some wonderful words from Danny Green to Kane Watts as Anthony Mundine looks on. And we are standing by in the middle of the ring. Benny Damon with Danny.
Well, Danny Green, that was rough. It was tough.
You must be pretty happy it's over.
Yeah, I am. Talk about pressure, man. It was heavy. So much pressure. It was like I was in a pressure valve, you know. It was hard. Hard to get my shots off because there's so much expectation, but you know what? I'm 43 years old, I'm not a young guy, so I did what I had to do against a bull. Cam Watts is an animal, you know, and he's the fittest he's ever been. That's why he was able to absorb more punishment than he normally does. His chin wasn't as good as that before this preparation, I'll tell you now.
You talk about the pressure. Do you think part of that is because there's so much at stake tonight for you?
Oh, there's always things at stake. You know, I've had a career where I've beaten Hall of Famers and lost to Hall of Famers and had some massive fights here and overseas against world champions, and you know, every fight's a big fight, and Kane had a great following. I want to thank all the people who came out to support Kane Watts. Well done, guys. It was a great atmosphere. You guys made it. That's what the sport's about. Everyone's got their fans. Everyone's got their supporters. Everyone's got their fighter. They love Kane Watts. So I want to say well done to Kane Watts. He's got a fantastic following. He's a ripping guy from all accounts. All I hear about how much of a good guy the bloke is. So it's easy to fight and get it on him. You know, we're pretty rough bloke, mate. I don't take much from it. He used his head. I used my head a little bit. He used his elbow. He tried to break my arm about 50 times. But I'm stronger than that young fella, so the old boy got a few tricks, so I'm happy to get the job done.
Now, Danny, there is an interested observer, as we've mentioned. He's sitting just over here. Anthony Mundine is here in the house. Would you like to say anything to him?
Just like to thank the sponsors, Ultra Tuner, and I thank Brian Armatura and Mick for putting the show on. Well done, boys. Great atmosphere, great show. To my sponsors, Invisiguard Boost Mobile. Also, I'm pretty passionate about Stop the Cowards Punch, as you all know, guys. It's a very important thing. I'm in here in the ring fighting as a professional fighter, but the message that's very clear Australia-wide, I want to thank all the media that's here tonight who've helped pump it and make it what it is, because I want to make this Stop the Cowards Punch a movement with every single person in here. There's no place for violence outside the ring. This isn't violence, this is sport. Congratulations, Kane Watt and his team. Put on a great show tonight, boys. I want to thank my beautiful wife and my kids, Chloe and Archie, at home. My beautiful dog, Yo-Yo, Buster, Rocky, Bozo,
right.
Now, guys.
Danny Green, will there
I want
be
to thank my team.
A rematch with Anthony Mundy?
Also, I want to thank Peter Critters and the awesome crew of Crown Resorts. You guys rock. And, of course, there'll be a rematch. I'll bug a mouse waiting to have you say, so bring him on and let him entertain you guys. That's what he does best.
OK, we assume it'll probably be here in Melbourne. When do you want to do it?
I'll do it tomorrow if he wants to do it. I'll do it now. I'm warmed up. Throw him some gloves. I've got enough energy for an old boy.
And tell me how you think it'll go when it does finally go down 10 years or 11 years after it first happened. You lost that fight. You said it's because of the weight. What happens this time around?
What happens is time takes, you know, a lot of, it took 10 years to get to this, I guess, this whole ordeal. It's been a saga. It's been crazy. We've had the limelight for 15 years. And credit to Chock. It's a credit to him, what he's done. He's raised the interest in the sport. He's a massive celebrity, but he's going to get smoked. He's going to get smoked like a cigar when I get hold of him. And I've got one more preparation under my belt. Give me a chance to do it, and I'll take care of business. But I'm right now, I'm just pretty sore, pretty tired. But, you know, I'm sure he's going to jump in. He's going to have his say. Look, this is a fight that's real. Chock thinks he's the best. I think I'm better than Chock. He's been a great athlete. I've been a great athlete for the sport. But it means something. He doesn't like me. I don't like him. That's when a fight means something. That's when it's important. And I don't like some of the shit that he says. And I don't like some of the shit that he stands for and the way that he inflames violence and division in the community. We had the chance to unite a community last fight. He chose to divide it. I want to do the same thing. I want to unite it. He can do whatever he wants.
So 100% in closing, your next fight and your last fight will be against Anthony Mundy.
Oh, look, mate, you're really putting me under the pressure here.
That's the idea.
I'm just looking to be victorious, mate. I want to right the wrong 10 years ago. It was very difficult for me. That's that. Let's get it on. Let's worry about what happens next, not what happened in the past.
All right, congratulations tonight, Danny Green. Well done.
And just one thing for Chock. I've got one message for Chock.
Danny Green, ladies and gentlemen.
Never short of a word. And Chock, with the head of security next to him, looking after things. As Danny Green makes his way out of the ring very, very quickly and into the dressing room. Danny Green, his winning ways continue over a super performance from Sugarcane Watts, who gave us his best tonight. It's certainly the best he has looked inside a professional ring in his 21 odd fights.